Welcome to the first chapter of Excel is Simple, a place where we'll bust some myths all around Excel and try to make it simpler to use. I think that it would be a professional disaster to have no or very less knowledge of Excel. Microsoft Excel is today a worldwide accepted standard for all your calculations and tables. While there are many open source alternatives to Microsoft Excel, it's still the most widely used spreadsheet and calculation application, given the ease of use and the kind of support provided by Microsoft. So how do we get started? Well, simple. Let's open Excel. There are many ways to start Excel you installed. You can click on the shortcut that you installed on your desktop, or just go to the Start menu, click All Programs, locate where Microsoft Office is lying, and then click on Excel. But my favorite, and believe me, I just started using it a few years back, press the Windows and R key together. It opens up the Run command dialog box, and then you just type the letters EXCEL and press Enter. Well, Excel opens up. So it's so simple, and it's fast too as well. And here I'd like to share with you an important tip. If you want to be fast with Excel, try to avoid using the mouse as much as you can. We'll soon be speaking about keyboard shortcuts and how to go to individual menus, etc. later. And there you can see how using the keyboard actually increases your speed. You may want to open an Excel sheet to actually practice what I'm saying. And the video, you can pause it anytime and rewind if needed. Okay, now that you have opened up Excel, you can have a look at the interface. And so the main components of Excel user interface are the quick access toolbar, the ribbon, formula bar, the worksheet area, and the status bar. This small toolbar can be seen at the top left corner of the Excel interface. By default, you can see the save, redo, undo commands. But then if you click that small drop-down icon here, you get the options to customize the quick access toolbar. There are some options like new, open, print that are available, plus an option to fully customize the toolbar, which you can actually do by clicking the more commands option. There you go. Now, almost all commands in Excel are available in this dialog box. Click on the one that you most frequently use. Say, I very frequently use the copy command. And then you click add. That's already there. So if I click copy, add, and then say OK, it starts appearing here in the quick access toolbar. You can also change the position of the quick access toolbar by clicking show below the ribbon. It's here. So your quick access toolbar comes below the ribbon. Or if you want to shift it back, you just click show above the ribbon. A ribbon contains most of the Excel commands. And I find this good when compared to the older versions of Excel that had pull-down menus, task panes, and toolbars. Ribbon brings Excel commands at your fingertips. Click on any tab and you'll see all the commands contained in the ribbon. Like right now we're on the home tab, you'll see all the home commands, insert, page layout, formula, data, review, view, add-ins. Beautiful interface and easy to use. Now, if you're using Excel to create forms and assign macros, you would want to add the developer tab to the ribbon. It's simple. Go to file, and then click options, and then the Excel options open up, and in that window you click customize ribbon. Now by default you'll find that the developer tab is unchecked in the ribbon. Put a check mark on this and click OK. You'll see the developer tab in the ribbon with all the options available over here. You would possibly see more tabs in the ribbon when you work on charts, tables, and graphics. That's the beauty of ribbon interface. You only see relevant tabs. The formula bar displays content of the current cell, and if you're using a formula in the cell, it will display the exact formula that is being used. While working on formulae or long text, sometimes it becomes difficult to see the entire text here in the cell. So what you can do is click on this particular cell and then just drag the formula bar a bit down and it will display all the contents that are there. While working on a formula, if you're stuck somewhere, you can simply click this FX icon on the formula bar and it will help you with the formula and you can actually use it to make it simpler. We will talk about this in detail when we are working on formula. On the left of your formula bar, you can see what is called as the name box. It identifies your current cell like this one here. You've got F1, or it will display your named list as well. Like this is a named list that I have prepared, or it will display just the selection. Worksheet is this area where you actually work. It's comprised of cells, which obviously are the building blocks of a spreadsheet. Now these cells are arranged into what's called as rows and columns. A row is a horizontal area that goes from left to right, and rows are indicated by numbers. When you click on the indicator number of a row, you are in turn selecting the entire row like this. Similarly, a column is a vertical area that goes from top to bottom and is indicated by letters. It starts from A and goes up to Z, and then from AA to AZ, BA to BZ, and so on. The number of rows and columns is one difference between the 2003 and later versions. While Excel 2003 had 65,000 rows, the later versions have more than a million. Similarly, Excel 2003 had a limited 256 column, while the later versions have around 16,000 columns. Rows and columns make an array, and the junctions are called cells. So each cell will have its own address, and this is what defines the cell. Let me help you with this. Here I'm going to this cell, and let me just highlight this so that it's sort of visible. You'll see the location is identified by the row and the column. See the row and the column highlighted in this case. It's the column G and the row number 5. So the address of this particular cell is G5. This you can also see here in the name box. Remember, this is a very important address. You will need this when you're using formulae. An identification of the cell address actually makes the work easier and faster. You will find quite some information in the status bar. A spreadsheet can have n number of tabs or worksheets where you can enter data. You can add worksheets here in the status bar, like this. Or you can remove worksheets by deleting them. You can even change the color of the tabs. Right click, tab color. Give it any particular color that you want, or you can even rename them, because by default what you get is sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3, and so on. If you have a large number of tabs in your spreadsheet, you'll see that these scroll buttons become active. Click on them and you'll see that you're able to navigate between those tabs like this. Then you also have an auto calculation indicator in the status bar. Let's say I've got three cells with the following values 2, 3, 4, and then I just select this area, and you'll see that in the status bar you'll have the average, count, and sum. You'll also find some layout options available here and zoom options available in the status bar. If you right click on the status bar, you'll see a whole lot of customization available for the status bar. Friends, this covers in a nutshell what the user interface for Excel looks like. In the next chapter, we'll talk about keyboard shortcuts you can use in Excel and try to understand how it makes our work faster. Post your comments and share the videos with your friends. Subscribe to the channel to get alerts on new videos.